and they got all the way to Zeta.
I was going to say, they didn't get to Omega.
They didn't get to Omega. Omega would have been the end.
That would have been bad.
But Zeta was six letters in. The peak of hurricane season happened on September 10th. That's the peak, typically, for the whole season. So we're past that, but we've got to get through the end of November before we're out of the season. Alpha already exists, by the way. They've already used it. So hopefully we don't hear more about that. Let's come back home. That's the view right now from the top of the Salesforce Tower, our exclusive view looking south. And yes, you can see a lot of haze out there. There's a lot of smoke in that view. But down on the ground, the air quality is good. And we've gotten used to this drill, right? There are two different ways to talk about smoke in our atmosphere. There's the stuff that's high up, and there's the stuff down on the ground where we're breathing. There's still plenty of it here in the mid and upper levels. I know that looks bad. But if you look at the actual sensors, they're all in the green. In fact, even down here in San Jose, where that camera was looking, off in the distance, it's always going to look worse the farther you look because you're looking through more of the atmosphere. But air quality is good. And it's good across the entire Bay Area. I showed you the forecast at the top of the newscast for why tomorrow it's going to go downhill. Here's a little bit more of the background as to why we're totally at the mercy of the wind now when it comes to the quality of the air we're going to be breathing. Right now, things are working in our favor because of this. Doesn't look like much there, but if you put it into the water vapor, you see the spin. It's a big area of low pressure that just came into the West Coast. That thing is dragging the atmosphere on from the coast. So there's a strong flow coming our way from the southwest. All the fires are the other way. There's almost just as much smoke being produced now as there had been, but we're lucking out because the mercy of the winds is working in our favor. But as that system moves onshore, watch what happens. You have to switch the way you look at this because it's not necessarily the upper levels that matter. If we come in for a close-up look, we're going to come down to the lower levels where we breathe in the air. Watch the streamlines change direction. That says tomorrow at 2:30. Now they're coming from the north. This is why I showed you that smoke forecast at the top of the newscast. Because as that flow changes, we've got the August complex over here. We've got the north complex over here. Those are both going to be able to throw their smoke our way for Sunday and probably even into Monday as well. But one other thing we've noticed on this is smoke forecasting is incredibly difficult. The fire of the behavior has to be factored in. And we really can't say what exactly those fires will be doing over the next 2 days. But at least as far as the winds, which is the most important aspect, tomorrow and Sunday, we'll probably see some more smoke come our way, which is why we go back to moderate. Overnight lows back down into the mid-60s. Daytime highs tomorrow bring us back up into the mid-80s if you're inland. You know, there's really no other story here in the weather forecast, weather-wise. It's all smoke all the time because there's nothing else coming our way, thankfully. We got our hands full as it is. It would be nice if we had a significant rainstorm come in, so I take that back. But in the absence of any rain, we'll keep a close eye on the wind, and we're going to keep talking about smoke. I'll see